the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us stand and sing our opening hymn, number 116, "In Thou Art Guardian and Our God." Genocide, and about how occupying powers destroy that which they come to supposedly take control and enhance. So we hold in our prayers this morning Ukraine, particularly the people of the city of Mariupol, as they face siege and bombardment. We join together in the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We will use a Lord Have Mercy confession this morning on page 3. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart God will not despise. Let us come to the Lord who is full of compassion and acknowledge our transgressions in penitence and faith. Wash away all my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We turn now to our Sunday sheet and the collect on the top of the left-hand side. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to the joy, but because he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord says this: everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labour for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me, listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We now sing the psalm, or should I say the choir will sing the psalm, and we join in the response, which is found at the bottom of the Sunday sheet. And we sing the response where it says, Ah.
Mm-hmm. Reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. I don't want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea, and all were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea, and all ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. Nevertheless, God was not pleased with most of them, and they were struck down in the wilderness. Now these things occurred as examples for us, so that we might not desire evil as they did. Don't become idolaters as some of them did, as it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink, and they rose up to play. We mustn't indulge in sexual immorality. Some of them did, and 23,000 fell in a single day. We mustn't put Christ to the test, as some of them did, and were destroyed by serpents. And don't complain, as some of them did, and were destroyed by the destroyer. These things happened to them to serve as an example. They were written down to instruct us, on whom the ends of the ages have come. So, if you think you're standing, watch out that you don't fall. No testing has overtaken you that is not common to everyone. God is faithful, and he will not let you be tested beyond your strength. But with the testing, he will also provide the way out, so that you may be able to endure it. For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There were some present who told Jesus about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. He asked them, "Do you think that because these Galileans suffered in this way, they were worse sinners than all other Galileans?" "No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all perish as they did." Or those 18 who were killed when the Tower of Siloam fell on them, do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others living in Jerusalem? "No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all perish just as they did." Then he told this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came looking for fruit on it and found none. So he said to the gardener, "See here, for 3 years I have come looking for fruit on this fig tree, and still I find none. Cut it down. Why should it be wasting the soil?" He replied, "Sir, let it alone for one more year, until I dig around it and put manure on it. If it bears fruit next year, well and good. But if not, you can cut it down." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. May the Lord speak to our minds today and renew our hearts.
Amen.
Well, I have been feeling angry and sad in equal measure. This criminal and futile war and the appalling human suffering it brings. Will we get any help with managing our feelings and our response from our worship and from Scripture this morning? I believe that we will. In the Church of England, we don't just pick the readings that we fancy each Sunday. We read the whole Bible on a cycle, so that sometimes you end up with readings that you think, oh my gosh. So our gospel reading today is a bit obscure. I will try and shed some light. It starts by mentioning an atrocity committed by the occupying Roman power. Not on the same scale as the atrocities we see daily at present in Ukraine, but nonetheless a brutal killing. And it's not mentioned in any other source outside the Bible. But it seems that the Roman governor, Pontius Pilate, had killed some of the people, some of the residents of Galilee, as they were offering sacrifices as part of their religious practice. And we don't know why. And another loss of life is mentioned. This one accidental, a tower collapsing in the Siloam suburb of Jerusalem. Now, there is this idea around, isn't there, that when bad things happen to people, they must somehow be to blame. And this crops up in various religions. Not Christianity, let me say. Okay, sometimes we are to blame for things that go wrong, as St. Paul recognised in our second reading today. But it would be completely wrong for us to think that suffering is always because of something we or other people have done wrong. That's not true. So Jesus, in the gospel today, is telling people not to blame victims. And if they want to think about sin and where it is, then to look inside themselves rather than looking outwards at other people. And that is pretty much the lesson of Lent for us. And if you are someone who listens to my sermons, you will have heard me say it before. But it is something that I don't mind saying again, because human beings need reminding of this, about looking inside at ourselves. And I say it to remind myself as much as anybody else. So we are here on earth, I think we'll all agree this, to lead lives that are fruitful. But, like the fig tree in the gospel, we don't always manage to do so. Like the fig tree in the church, oh, that's also true, it does produce figs, but you can't eat them. But God gives us another chance on the occasions when we fail, like the gardener in the story that Jesus tells, applying manure to the fig tree that is not producing figs. And Lent is a time of manure. It is the time when we receive the grace which God gives us so that we may be fruitful. As a keen gardener, and I know some of you are not, so I apologise for that, I do dig manure into the ground before growing vegetables on the allotment and flowers in the garden. This doesn't give instant results, but later and gradually it is of benefit to the plants. So also with us at the moment. Our time of prayer and reflection in Lent our time of looking at ourselves and studying the Bible. I'm so glad that so many people are taking part in the Lent study course. Our time of studying the Bible doesn't give instant results, though sometimes it does. But rather, it gives us some planning and thinking time, some focus for the things that we know deep down that we are called to do. And also it gives us the courage and the self-belief to do them, and the persistence and the patience to see them through. Being still and quiet is a good thing in itself, because we come near to God. We recognise God's presence in our lives. It's also a good thing because we are more likely then to hear and to follow God's guidance for us. And so our actions will be more effective because they are guided by God and not just undertaken on some whim of our own. Some years ago, you probably remember, it was fashionable for people to talk about hitting the ground running. It was the image of a dynamic person in business, powerful, energetic. But the trouble is, without the thought and the reflection first, we could indeed hit the ground running, but we might be running in the wrong direction. So let's spend time with God this Lent and discover what God's will is for us as members of the Church of God of Christ, which is local and global. From my own prayer and reflection this Lent so far, I am drawn to Jesus calling us to be peacemakers. In the context of the present war, it may end more quickly if we are prepared to tell our government that we will suffer some hardship ourselves for the sake of those who are suffering so terribly. The war is waged by a state that sponsors fake news and disinformation. Unfortunately, this is a worldwide trend as well. People do not trust authority, and who can blame them when they see what kind of people often have authority? People speak, don't they, about the post-truth society. As Christians, we believe in the truth about Jesus. Jesus' words are timeless and true, and we can live by them. Jesus showing God's love on the cross and in his resurrection are a truth that can change us forever. So perhaps we can contribute to a society where people seek the truth and listen to each other without exaggerating, lying and smearing. Perhaps we can begin by engaging with people who hold views that we don't personally like. Not so much to argue as to listen and understand. Wars and feuds often begin out of fear of the unknown and the different. So right now, the war occupies us, I'm sure. But we should, at the same time, be always building bridges. Action for peace in the future depends on it. In this Eucharist, we are bound together with bonds of love. It is a love which embraces the whole world. Thank you for listening.
In the words of the Nicene Creed, where we remember the faith which is bound together in love.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus. gods and not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With confidence and trust, let us pray to the Father.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Almighty and ever-loving God, you are more ready to hear us and forgive us than we are to come to you. Forgive us for the times we have sinned and failed you. Strengthen us as we seek to serve you, that we may follow you in the ways of peace and love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we look for you, we long for you, our whole being thirsts for you and your love. Lord, open our eyes, awaken us to what is around us and make us aware of your coming. We pray for all who tend and nurture the young in the faith, for all who are growing in awareness of you and your world. May the Church be an instrument of justice and peace in our community. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, as you have given us this world to live in, help us to use its riches and resources with sensitivity. Bless and guide all who are working on the land. We pray for all who supply our food and our daily needs, all who are involved in research with crops and cultivation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We give thanks for our homes and our loved ones. We pray for our places of work. May we be faithful and honest in our dealings. Make us sensitive to each other's needs and hopes. We pray especially for homes with young children. We give thanks for the release of Nazanin Zahari Ratcliffe, at last back with her family in the UK. Also Anousheh Ashouri. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We continue to pray for the people of Ukraine, those killed, bereaved, and displaced. We hope and pray for an end to the war with Russia. And we also pray for all other war-torn places in the world. God of peace, comfort the crying and heal the hurt. Tend the aching and soothe the fearful. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have been taken ill this day or been involved in accidents. We remember friends and loved ones who are ill, especially Eileen having surgery on Wednesday, Emerald, Dorian and Malcolm, Vera, and the residents of Winchester House. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, you are our helper and you protect us from all evil. We pray for all who will face death today, for our loved ones departed, that you will bring them into the fullness of joy in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful Father,
I accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please stand for the peace. since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
In a moment, we'll continue our worship with our second hymn, number 358, Be Still for the Presence of the Lord. But I want to assure you that you're all welcome to receive communion in one kind currently, or a blessing at the altar as you feel fit. And if you would like us to come to your seat, then please just let us know. So we sing out here. Spirit into flesh, As your son born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks, because he was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Our Father,
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we will share in one bread.
Thank you.
say together, Almighty God,
we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
We stand and sing our final hymn, our very uplifting. Number 708, lift up your hearts.
Style of singing for a change next week.